Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Tell you, thank the Lord for our sister and pastor being back in the house of the Lord. So glad to see you. So glad to see you. You were truly missed. Amen. Thank you, praise God, for our first lady, a woman among women, an awesome vessel of God, an awesome blessing of God. I'm excited about that. An awesome blessing of God. Amen. We have an awesome blessing of God sitting in our midst this morning. Amen. Praise God. And I say that because Bishop couldn't be Bishop the way he is Bishop without this woman being the kind of woman she is. Because if she was a hellion, not only would he be gray, he would be bald. Can you imagine Bishop putting a little toupee on the top of his head because Sister Barlow would word it out? He couldn't talk about our weeds then, huh? Or he'll find a way. Amen. Truly, it's a blessing to be in the house of God. A true blessing to be in the house of God. And I just don't want to be before you no longer than the Spirit say so. Amen. Is that all right? Yeah. I want all my men to stand up. Men. Well, the little boys, too, if that's what we're going to take. Come on, man. Amen. Men among men. Men, I charge you this morning. I charge you this morning to be a light. I charge you this morning to be the strength and the backbone in this congregation. Not only in this congregation, I charge you this morning to be the head of your household. I charge you to take charge of your family. I charge you this morning to take charge of your finances. I charge you this morning to take charge of your relationship. I charge you this morning to be a husband among husbands. I charge you this morning to be a father among fathers. I charge you this morning to do everything that God has called you to be. I charge you men to never ever let another woman, another child, another boy, another girl slip through your hands when you had an opportunity to reach that soul. I charge you this morning to be the watchman on the eyes of the church. I charge you this morning that whatever goes on, you will be in tune with the Spirit. I charge you this morning. And after I charge you, the Word of God said, I will bless you. And I bless you to do everything that was charged upon you because you are our light, you are our leaders, and we need strong men to lead us. We need strong men to lead us, and we're counting on you to be those men. Amen? Let the congregation give the men of God a hand. Thank you. Now you women, let's get to you. No. We don't want no more rubbernecking and popping off. Shut your mouth.
Yes, come on, man. Come on.
Shut your mouth and let a man be a man. Okay? You know, I see, it's just really funny. To me, maybe you don't think it's funny, but me, I'm ready to break down and laugh. The loudest clapper is a single woman. The loudest person clapping is a single woman. Because I said, keep your mouth closed. And she's applauding that. And I pray that God would bless you with a man that will sweep you completely off of your feet. I'm asking. asking God to send a priest that will surprise you, make you think that you had never been alive before. I ask God to bless you upside down, across town, every which way you turn. I ask God to bless you. In the name of Jesus. Because unless you can take rebuke, you can't stand to be blessed. Amen? Praise God. I mean, now the ladies, y'all don't be mad with me now. You had your chance. I'm joking. Amen. Let's go. Let's go to Romans, the 12th chapter, starting at verse 1.
I urge you, therefore, brothers, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service of worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is the good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
That sounds familiar. Go back to the verse before you finished. Back a verse.
Okay.
Just read. I'll tell you if you're right.
I urge you, therefore, brothers, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies as a living sacrifice.
Okay, right there. Paul is telling us, you know, to present our bodies. See, we want to come to church all decorated on the outside, and the inside is messed up. But let me tell you something this morning. God gave me this to tell the church this morning. You got to get your foundation correct.
Amen.
Your foundation has to be correct. And any woman know that it don't matter how pretty that dress is, if you don't have the right foundation, and I'm not talking about makeup. If you don't got the right foundation, that beautiful dress will not hang right. Where it's supposed to flow, it's kind of stuck. And y'all know what it's stuck on. It get lost in them crevices. Have you ever seen yourself in the mirror? You just fully dressed and you know you just got it. You know you're ready to step out. And you walk by a mirror and you look and you're like, well, when them little humpbacks get in my bag? You know, you ain't got the right, you don't have the right foundation on. So what I'm trying to say, when you get ready to present your body as a living sacrifice, you got to have the right foundation. Amen? You got to have the right foundation. And the thing that we do, we try to come to church, sway with the choir, say amen. And I don't need you to say amen, because see, I brought my amen with me. Say amen and holler and scream at the preacher and think you're going to make us preach ourselves to death. It's not going to happen. But you know what you do? We just come to a form of godliness, denying all the power that's within. Because you got so much on the outside, you're not taking care of the inside. And we wonder why. I've been praying for all these years. I've been praying for my husband to be saved for so many years. And I asked God one day, I say, where did I mess up? Where did I mess up? I'm the sanctified one, and I'm supposed to be able to pull him. Where did I mess up? And I'm sitting around there beating myself down. Where did I mess up? This man is still not saved. Where did I mess up? Spirit said, remember, every man is given a will. I said, thank you, Lord. I thought when I told him I would knock his blankety blank off, that was it. When I told him I would, you know, anyway. Now, I'm not the only person that have gotten so angry that we just start saying all kind of crazy things. You start saying things, and then you get back and you think about some of the things you say. He was like, that was not me. That was not me. But But that's how the enemy play us. Amen. He allow us to get so taken aback with the situation that we forget that we're saved. We forget that we have the Holy Ghost. We forget to tap into the Holy Ghost. We forget to even listen to the Holy Ghost. So we just override, just to pull the Holy Ghost down this stomach. Give me some air. Give me some air. Let me up, please. I got some. Help me. But I'm here this morning to tell you, get the foundation right. Get your foundation right. And he said, I beseech you. I'm asking you. I'm asking. I'm almost begging you. To present your body as a living sacrifice. I'm asking you with a sincere desire to see great things come out of you. Because I know there's something great on the inside. So I'm not going to settle for what I see on the outside. You know, we quick to judge, look at her. Look at her dress is so tight. But her spirit might be just as tight. So you sitting there watching me on the outside. You don't know what I looked like when I first got up this morning. God, I don't want to know what I looked like when I first woke up this morning. And don't laugh, because a lot of y'all can't stomach you when you get up in the morning. And you married women, y'all going to argue with bad breath. He ain't running to get away from you. Don't wanna, he ain't not in agreement. He's just trying to get. Yes, honey. Yes, darling. Yes, honey. And I said, oh, yes. Girl, I got my husband. He do just what I know. He's trying to get the heck out of your face. In other words, wash up before you start breaking up. You missed that, didn't you? Wash up before you start breaking up. Before you start breaking up your relationship with God. Before you get yourself straight. Get on the right side. Get on the right foundation. Get yourself straight and prepare yourself to go to the next level. You can't go to the next level taking the same old devil. Amen. You got to get rid of some of that dead weight. We walk around here with all this animosity in our heart and we think God don't know it. You can't fool God. You trying to fool man and get man told, and God say, that's a time you got on your knees. You should have just stayed in the bed. Because I'm not listening to you this morning. Don't bring all that garbage and lay it before God and think he's going to overlook you. Open your mouth and ask for forgiveness. Open your mouth and ask for forgiveness. You want to slam the dog, kick the cat, cuss out the babies, run them over, and then you want to come and ask God, don't you dare. Get your foundation right. Ask God to forgive you and give you a clean heart. Because God is looking for righteousness, no matter what the devil's telling you, no matter what, we get so consumed with everything that's going on in the world. We think we got to be conformed with everything that's going on. Ain't enough righteousness in you to spell it. Talking about the expected end. Yeah, your behind gonna be lost if you don't get it together. Don't sit in the sanctuary and go to hell. Come on now. Don't sit up in the sanctuary where the word of God is coming from and end up in hell. Let me tell you something. God got to be first and foremost, or he don't want nothing to do with you. There is no gray area. It's either black and white, hot or cold. There ain't no lukewarm position in the kingdom. You may as well get on board. Girl, I was just joking. You was a lie. You wasn't joking. You just got caught. I'm just sorry if I hurt you. You know doggone well what you said was out of order. Amen. When people come to tell me, if you got to guess, if you just guessing that you might have offended me, then you keep that because you are not even ready to apologize.
Right.
If I said anything, brother, to offend you, what if I told you your shirt was on crooked and it just looked a hot mess? And what did I say that was edifying to him? Nothing. So I know I said something wrong. So don't try to make yourself look good. Let God wipe you and clean you up.
Amen.
I'm sorry. This shirt look all right, but you know I was just, no, shut up and go sit down. Nobody got no time to sit around and listen to you try to play games with God, and you're losing at that.
Right.
What foundation? Give me Psalms 11th chapter. Psalms start at verse 3. I'm talking about having on the righteous mind of Christ. Amen. The righteous mind of Christ. The righteous mind of Christ is going to make you apologize, even if they don't even think that you did anything to them. I had people walk up to me and apologize. Well, you know, Sis Mo, such and such. I'm like, what? Oh, baby, I don't even remember that. But I just thought that I was just going to apologize. I just want you to know I love you. And baby, I love you too. Then when you get down the road, you be like, what the hell I say? You be all concerned and loving and kind, and then you get the thing, you get down walking down the road, and you be like, wait a minute. You say, what? Let me see you. No. Read.
If the foundations be destroyed, what can the righteous do?
My question. If your foundation is destroyed with lies, hypocrisy, backbiting, blasphemy, criticizing, all the negativity. You know, every young girl coming to church, you're going to tear her down because she got your body that you had 30, 40 years ago. You still got the same body. You just kept feeding it. It's in there somewhere. It's in there. She just hadn't had as many meals as you had. She been leaving neck bones and collard greens and back bones and turnip greens and peas and greens and cornbread and greasy cornbread and all that stuff. She just ain't got to that yet. You look at them and say, girl, you missed some good eating. That make you feel better than to see that time. Look at her. That thing is really just tight as it can be. And yours used to be the same way. And Bishop said last week, he said, people be lying, talking about the dress got too small. Now, y'all know. I'm just being honest. I look at my wedding dress and all I can do is look at it. I wonder who used to wear that. Woo. Jesus. Dress in this closet. I don't go well. That wasn't nobody in this house. And that dress looking at me, talking about, you used to wear me heifer. You remember that day? You remember good, remember? We just keep changing and putting in the wrong thing, putting the wrong things in our bodies, in our spirits. You can't absorb negativity and expect positive results. You know what I'm saying? Somebody told me the other day, said, the other morning I was talking and my brother was saying that he want prayer for being selfish. Be careful. Be careful how you label yourself. Amen? Because just because you're not able and have the time to do all the things that you want to do for God, don't mean that in the midst of you doing what you got to do, you can still be praising and worshiping God. Yes, hallelujah. Lord, I praise you. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, I thank you. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus. And nobody got nothing to do with what's going on in your mind. But you. But don't label yourself as being anything but a child of God. I was a backslidden old sinner. I was sitting there. I told somebody this other day, I'm like, you? Oh, yeah. This heifer was bad, too. Sitting there, I was smoking my little cigarette and put my cigarette out. And I come out of my mama's house and just sitting around because my mama was old school. Such a Bradley, such and such and such. I'm like, I ain't even got the cigarette smell off my hand. She talking about some kind of Sister Bradley. Minister Bradley, so and so, so and so. I'm like, Mom, why do you keep calling me Minister Bradley? Because I call those things that are not as though they were. I am not accepting the fact that you are not saved. I'm not accepting and I'm not accepting. And you can't make me. Oh, okay. Ooh, shouldn't have said nothing about that. And she would never call me. I was saying I was backsliding. My mama never called me a backslider. She never told one of us that we were sinners. Never. And her prayer was, God, whatever it takes, not one of mine will go to hell. Whatever it takes. But see, the thing we got to be careful of now is that we can't afford for the enemy to rob us of our foundation. Because what you going to do if you don't have a foundation to stand on? Do you not know that when they're building a house? Help of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Yeah, surrender it all, baby. Surrender. And she's going to make me so mad. God, I know when she popped that baby out, she's going to be like, bam, bam, boom, again. But anyway, can't stand her. But anyway. I love that girl. And don't let her church flow through you. That is a crazy woman. Amen. Read verse 4, baby.
The Lord is in his holy temple. The Lord's throne is in heaven. His eyes behold, his eyelids try the children of men.
Keep reading.
The Lord trieth the righteous, but the wicked in him that loveth violence, his soul hateth.
Isn't that sad? Isn't that sad? Read that verse again, sweetheart.
The Lord trieth the righteous, but the wicked in him that loveth violence, his soul hateth.
Read.
Upon the wicked he shall rain snares.
Look. Take a close inventory of your life right now. A close inventory of your life right now. Hear what she said, the Lord hateth. Anybody know what the Lord, what she said? The Lord hateth. And the thing, not only does he hate wickedness, he allowed it to rain snares, traps, killing, robbing, shooting, beating, confusion, abuse, all these things. That's because they're wicked. So if this is going on in your household, you got to get your foundation straight. Because you're not wicked. My mom said, I said, ooh, this way is, man, I tell you, it's so hard to be saved. Well, God, Lord have mercy. Oh, Lord, mama, it used to, don't nobody raise your hand because if you do, I'm going to make you feel like I felt. it's just hard. You just don't know. It's just hard to live saved. Oh, I just can't believe it. I mean, everything, just seems like everything is going wrong. Oh, no. And she did it in a little South Carolina boy. She said, baby, she said, the word of God said, the way of the transgressor is hard. Are you a transgressor? What the heck she talking about? The way of the transgressor is hard. Which means that if all this stuff is raining down in our homes and our lives and our families, we have really walked away from the foundation of our faith. We're not praying. Our faith is not renewed. We have the same mindset that we had when we started coming to church. And the scriptures say we're supposed to be what? Renewing our mind. Which means that same mind that you got when you came up out of that water and decided that you was going to walk with God, walk with Christ, and this is your life now. You're not going to change your mind. That's the same mind you should have now. Your first love. Come back to your first love. You got the same mind. I told somebody the other day, I said, you know what? The same mind means that, you know, you come in the sanctuary all surrendered to God, and then you don't go back, because you come back to the sanctuary time and time again to get more and renewing of your mind and renewing of your spirit so that you can get better. You will be better, because there's what? There's help in the sanctuary. You will not be successful in the sanctuary with your mind in the streets and your body showing up on Sunday morning.
Right.
Yeah, we see your body sitting here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, I see you sitting here, but where's your mind? Oh, she ain't preaching no hallelujah. No, I'm not either. I'm just giving you what the Lord said to give to you this morning. Apparently God knew who was going to be here and who needed it. I knew a renewing of the mind. We come in here. One day we're up here. Next day we're down here. Come here. Let me get somebody young. I can't be doing this. Come here, J-Day. No, Tony, I'm not there. Okay. Go up there. One day you're up down. Next day, come on down, baby. Come on, you're going to be stepping. Now you go to the, come there. Come there, step. One day you're halfway. And you feel real good about halfway. Then the next day you're right back down. Back up. Back down. No expected end in sight. Back up. Back down. Back up. Back down. Come halfway. Now stay right there. Come here. Let me get volunteer right quick. Come here. Anybody, just get up more. Come on. My assistant pastor's good for that. Because I prophesied on her and Virtuous Woman class doing the same thing. I couldn't believe that. Now, he halfway there, right? So now he going to try. Come over here and help your assistant pastor. Help her up. Help her up. Go ahead, help her up. Now look where he is. He done, that's Paul said, you got to pray. You got to pray that the people that you reach out to save don't exceed you and you're lost. You got to, get not another little son, not another little son. You got to pray. You got to be on one accord yourself that you don't mess around and you trying to save somebody else and you lose your soul. The foundation. Now turn around, pastor, and bring him up there where you are. Now, tell me that does look a lot better than him way down there trying to help up. We are going to win. We're not to touch your neighbor. Touch your neighbor. Come on, baby, y'all, come on. Touch your neighbor and say, you're not going to lose this fight. Not sitting by me. You're not going to lose this. Not sitting by me. I refuse it. I call it as it's not. I call you know, a revival done kicked off. I said, the next thing you know, a revival done kicked off. Kicked off in me. Kicked off in you. But it kicked off in me. Get up. Get your neighbor's hand. Hold on to your neighbor. Don't let him fall. Hold on to your neighbor. And you pray over that soul. No, God. Not on my watch. Not on my watch. You're not going to be lost on my watch. Not on my watch. You did last night. Who cares? Don't care what you did this morning. Who cares? I don't care what bed you got up out of. Who cares? You're here now, and we're gonna pray for you right now in the name of Jesus. Pray like it's your soul. Pray like it's your baby. Pray like it's your brother. Pray like it's your sister. Not on my watch. You walked around here and you came on holy ground. Not on my watch. Hallelujah. Not on my watch. Nobody will be shooting at you no more. Not on my watch. Nobody will be selling you no drugs. Not on my watch. Nobody will be claiming you a member of no gang. Not on my watch. Not on my watch. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, consecrate right now, in the name of Jesus, order their steps right now, in the name of Jesus, cover them right now, in the name of Jesus, change that heart right now, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. This morning you put on the whole arm of God. Let's act like we got it going on. We got a war going on over here. Nobody, not a soul. We will not bury not a one. Not a one. Not a one. In the name of Jesus, cut him up, my son. My child will come home. My son will come home. My job will let me go because I got my own business. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes. Yes. Astray. Pray, church. Pray for turnaround. Pray for turnaround. Come out of your bosom. Jesus. Jesus. Can't even recognize my children. Can't even recognize my own child. My own flesh and blood. They turned so far away from where they started from. Hallelujah. But God, we come this morning to serve the enemy notice that we will snatch them back. We will snatch them back. Out of the pits of hell, we'll snatch them back. Jesus, Jesus, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah, in Jesus' name, give the Lord a hand, thank you, Jesus. You may take your seat, you may be seated. I want to share something with you, and I'm done. When God called me to preach, I was fighting so hard not to do it. Thank you. I was fighting so hard. Got my mom as a preacher. God knows I don't want to do this. Please, anybody else, call my sister. Anybody else, just don't call me, please. So one night, I left home, went to the car wash, washing my car, and the scripture came to me. Matthew 7, 22, 27. I think it's more than appropriate right now. If I tell you who my audience was at the car wash, you would think it would be more beneficial for you. Read, baby, starting at verse 22.
Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? And in thy name have cast out devils?
Oops. Go ahead.
And in thy name done many wonderful works?
Oops.
And then will I profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity.
Oh, yeah. I'm Nene. You remember me? I'm Nene. You remember you saved me? I'm Nene. And with all the alterations and the falsified things going on in the world today, how God can recognize you except he can have a spiritual connection? Because your eyes are not the same color. Your hair was dashed long and now it's down your back. You were straight as a board and now you got curves galore. You know you had bald eyelashes. You had nothing there. The teeny-weeny. You know y'all had them little teeny-weeny eyelashes. Now y'all batting like y'all can. I ain't talking about my family. You can't. Be batting your eyes, flies be flying off, scared to come by. Mosquitoes say, how can God recognize you except by a spiritual connection? We just do so many things. Amen? And then you get to the point where you think you're doing such a great work, letting an enemy use you, and then you're going to get up here and say it was God. It was God. And then you have to wonder and worry that he going to tell you, I don't know you. But I was the one that gave away the whole house. But God knows. You know, I'm going to have to use another example. Because we had a little incident in Bellevue when KT lived in Bellevue. There was this loud noise. Then there was complete silence. Phew. I looked out the window, the wind wasn't blowing. I looked around, there was no cars driving. I didn't see, the curtain wasn't even moving. Everything was at a standstill. I got on the phone. Okay, hello? Okay, KT, you still here. It wasn't a rapture. Woo, that was close, man. If he wouldn't have answered that phone, I probably would have been still running. You know how many years it's been that Kristen and KT lived in Bellevue? Anyway. I done did all these great and mighty works on the earth saying it was God. And God said, I didn't know you. What would make him not know who you are? Your foundation. What are you doing it for? If you're doing it just to get a pat on the back, that's your reward. And sometimes you are actually doing the right thing with the wrong motives. He said, do all things to the what? To the glory of God. Do everything. If you give your offering, give it to because it's the glory of God and it's the right thing to do. Not to sit there and see it. I'ma see it. I'ma see it, Barlow. And don't ever talk to me calling my pastor Barlow either, because I will embarrass you. I'll see a Barlow gonna call my name. He gonna spend your money and put you out at the same time. Because you can't buy your way to heaven.
Right.
Your tithe and offering, you're not giving that to him, you're giving that to God. That's a godly principle. And you're sitting here trying to figure out what, just leave it alone. Don't get yourself in more trouble than you're already in. Finish reading, baby. Read, baby, read. Hurry up so we can get out of here. These people are tired of me, and I'm getting tired of looking at some of them little stuff.
Therefore, whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man which built his house upon a rock.
On a rock. Now that's the wise man. And what does the foolish man do? Read, baby.
And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew, and beat upon that house, and it fell not.
Right.
It was founded upon a rock. And everyone that heareth these sayings of mine, and doeth them not, shall be likened unto a foolish man, which built his house upon the sand. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew, and beat upon that house, and it fell.
And what? And what happened to the house on the sand? It fell. So I'm telling you, that's what God is looking for you to do. A solid foundation. Jesus is that rock. Build your foundation on Christ Jesus. It won't fail you.
Amen.
It won't fail you. But see, we get so busy sometimes. We think that we can just, God is so desperate. He so desperately wants our company and our praise that he will, you know, he'll just take anything. So we're the ones that building that house up on sand. Well, I'll tell you about this little scripture that God gave me. And I'm out there washing my car and I'm just a preacher. Don't build your house on the sand. Build it on the rock. Build it on the rock. Hallelujah. Build it on the rock. Build it on the rock. Don't sink in sand. Hallelujah. I'm just a praise in your name. Glory. Hallelujah. I opened my eyes. It was about 12 cats. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the spirit got good. I got to shout a little bit. Open my eyes at 12 cats like this. I don't know if there was a 12 disciples. Or the 12 cats from Halloween. But it wasn't long. Church, I said it wasn't long. And Sister Mo got in her car and drove on down the road. I had a little speed. I had a little speed behind me. I didn't just go slowly, but I was running. Now, y'all see, all I was thinking, Lord, let me look back and see them cats coming behind me. I was scared to look in the rearview mirror. I was taken out in the spirit. I was preaching so hard. Because, you know, you when you don't be obedient to God, you don't know when God gonna make a fool of you. Ain't no telling. There ain't no telling when God might just say, well, I'm just gonna leave you out here. I sung with this group, Amber Harris. I don't know, that's not this little girl that got killed. This is another lady, Amber Harris. And we're singing, and she was done told us what song we was going to sing. And that was the one she said the Lord told her to sing. So we got, now her song, she wrote the song, everything, her song, period. That's like Mary Lee forgetting the song that she wrote. And the music just playing and playing and playing. Every time it break for her to come in, she said, just the guy go do the little intro again. So we're back in the background. We just want to walk out and I said, What's the matter? God, I can't remember the words. I said, the word. I We just were moving like nothing happened. She opened her mouth and the whole building was on fire. I mean, the anointing was there. Because we can't do it. I would like to come out here and tell y'all a little story and go home. But that's not what God told me to do. And the Lord wants you to know something. This is not your rehearsal ground for the kingdom. This is not where God wants you to rehearse being in the kingdom. Get this? This is not where you rehearse how to be in the kingdom. Amen? Because this is an act. We're not. How many of us act just like, except me? Because I'd be preaching all the time. I'd be preaching my grandkids. They don't even want to come around me. They don't. They cash out over the corner. Look at her. So, yeah. But anyway, we'll all be in a state of mind of praise and worship like we are in the sanctuary. And it's hard for us to do that in here. I don't know why. The God that woke you up this morning, you didn't get no bad news. You can call on your kids and they will answer. Amen. If you got your parents alive and you can call them and they can tell you have a good day, I don't know what would you not want to praise God for? You didn't wake up with IV all running on your arms and you going down to the cancer unit. I don't know what would make you not want to praise him. I don't know what it was. Why would somebody have to pump you up to praise a God that's been this good to you? When you look back in your yearbook and you count all the people that graduated with you or went to school with you, no longer here, why would you want to praise God? Look at the fools God took out of your life. Why wouldn't you want to praise God? Why wouldn't you want to praise God? Come in here like you done got stuck on a lime truck. A lemon don't make you look like that. God want that a long time with you. And let me give you these four examples that God gave me. And you can do what with them, whatever you want. It blessed me, hoping that it bless you. God want us to be alone with him, one-on-one. Amen? It's all right that you on the road with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 people. But what is it like when you're by yourself? Give me that chair right there, Marcus, please. Day Day, you the one. Just sit it right there. All right. God want to be alone with you. Intimately with you. He want a relationship so deep with you that nothing can penetrate it. So when you go Matthew 26, because there's going to come a time when you're going to have times of the Garden of Gethsemane. On your knees, baby. Hit your knees. Baby, turn back this way. Don't let them see you sweat. Pray, Day-Day. Pray, baby, pray. Read, sweetheart, verse 36.
Then cometh Jesus with them unto a place called Gethsemane, and saith unto the disciples, sit ye here while I go and pray yonder.
And you notice that Jesus didn't take the disciples with him, right? Because see, there's some times when you're facing things in your life, you can't afford to have a friend to go with you. You can't even afford, I know you love Kenny to death, but it's a time that you're going through some stuff, personal stuff, between you and God, Kenny can't go with you. So you got to go, have that Gethsemane experience where you go and sweat and pray and cry out to God until God delivers. And sometimes the people that are looking at you, he may not even understand why she crying like that, why she praying, because he don't know what you're getting ready to face. He don't understand, because that's between you and God. See, it's a difference when you are one in the flesh. It's another thing when you become one with God in the spirit. because your concerns are whatever that's concerned that concerns God. Whatever concerns God and concerns your walk with God, that's where you want to be. And sometimes you got to get to that Gethsemane experience, get to that garden by yourself and cry out. I don't know about anybody else. Have you ever been through something and you know nobody could understand? You try to explain it and they's looking at you like you crazy. When you try to look like you're doing something different, they're looking at you crazy, but you stay there. You stay there. Until God gets through with you, you can get up, baby. I know you done prayed so hard. All right, Revelations 1. This is the Patmos experience. Now, I can voluntarily tell you that I've had that experience. God took me to the island of the Philippines, and I had a Patmos experience. Surrounded by millions, but I'm standing alone. No connection with church, home church, no connection with home, no connection with family, just me, God, and the devil that was laying in the bed by me. Me, God, and the devil that was laying beside me. And I wondered, is this my expected end? Is this all you got for me? You're going to bring me 3,000 miles away from home for me to just sit here and die? For this man to do whatever he wished to do, and I got to sit here and die? And late in the midnight hour, everybody sleep. And I get this knock in my spirit. And God said, I heard you cry. And I'm going to take you through. Get up the next morning. My mom don't call because this time we didn't have the capability to call like you do now. My mama, who don't believe in no big telephone bill, called me from South Carolina to Clark Air Force Base in the Philippines. The phone rang, and I go, hello? Mozella? Yes, ma'am. Mama! Hush, 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 hush. God said, she said, God said, don't you worry, it's gonna be all right. Oh, thank you, Jesus, mama. That was it. But I remember what he had told me at midnight. He sent a phone call 3,000 miles away. They had no idea what he had told me that night. And she said, that's all I call you to say. God told me to call you and tell you everything is going to be all right. I was on the Isle of Patmos getting a revelation. You got to get by yourself so that God can reveal things to you. You can't do it when you're in the crowd. You got to be by yourself. You will not die in this. You will not be taken down in this. You will succeed. I have covered you. 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 Hey God, I have covered you. Hold on, my son. On the Isle of Patmos, getting a revelation from God. On the Isle of Patmos, and then you get to the point, hallelujah, that he want to get by your side. He want to get with you one-on-one when you're down in the valley of the shadow of death. When you say, oh, well, you will fear no evil. You will fear no evil because thou art with me. Where can I go? Where can I go and not run into the Lord? Where can I go? Jesus. Hallelujah. Like Moses on the mountaintop, he was all by himself. And God said, I gotta talk with you, Moses. So let the sheep and the lambs go that way. But you come here, boy. I got something to show you. I want to show you that I am that consuming power. Everything that you think matters, I'm consuming it right now. Everything that you thought was short and you could not afford to do and you could not do, God said, I consume that right now in the name of Jesus. I will burn it up. I won't even give the enemy the joy of thinking that my own. I let my God let his own down. Well, God let his own down. When everything is against us, he said, well, he's more than the whole world against us. Can you afford to let God down? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The consuming power of God, that righteous mind. That's what God wants from us. He wants that righteous mind. He wants you to say your nay, your yay, yay, and that's where you are. Don't come in here saying I'm a saint of God. I belong to grace. And as soon as you hit the door, it's an MF for this and an MF for that. Ah, I think not, honey. I think not, brother. She can't be all the names that you call her out there if she's a child of God in here. You better watch yourself before you be by yourself. God is not setting the stage for fools. He's not setting it. It don't matter what you've been through. Whatever you are going through, God has the power to take you out of it. He's able to bring you out. If he was able to cause Lisa Mills' dad to walk, who else said was not going to walk?